All right, are rabbits ruining your garden? if they are, you're not alone. I personally, our garden has never looked as bad as it does this year. The little...
Do you not have a little fence around it?
It's complicated. So you remember this headline? I want to show you this from last summer. This was in Florida. When lionhead rabbits established a colony after being legally let loose by a backyard breeder.
Right.
Remember this? This was just north of Fort Lauderdale.
Well, hopefully you don't have this situation at your house or in your neighborhood. John Logering is a professor at the University of Minnesota Crookston. He's also a wildlife specialist, and he's here to talk all about rabbits with us this morning. Hi, John.
Hey, good morning.
Okay, so we don't have quite the rabbit infestation that they were dealing with in Fort Lauderdale last year, but there do seem to be more of them this year, and I'm not crazy in thinking that, right?
Well, I think there's, it's really hard to say. This time of year is a perfect time for rabbits. They have an incredible reproductive capacity, and all the reproduction that they've done this year is now just, all those little bunnies are out hopping through your yard. The light winter last winter may have been a benefit, but, it's no surprise. Everyone is seeing lots of rabbits right now. I guess I should say that, remember those cottontail rabbits you see in the urban environment, it's a real blessing that we live in a place where that much wildlife can come into our yards. Chris, I know gardeners, they seldom have something good to say about how cute rabbits are, right? They really, really don't like them.
But we've not grown
orchard owners and that sort of thing.
Yeah, for sure. And we've not grown one strawberry. They have taken every single one of our strawberries. We've never had this happen before. I've never seen so many of them. And I had no idea. One rabbit, a mom can have 10 to 12 babies in a year.
You've heard the phrase breed like rabbits. Well, it's well founded. Here in Minnesota, we can have those cottontail rabbits might have 4 to 6 young in a litter, and they might have anywhere from 3 to 4 litters per year. So, you assume the worst case scenario, you got great habitat, you have 6 rabbits times 4 breeding attempts. Well, that's 24 youngsters running around. So the 2 rabbits you saw in your backyard in March made 26 by the end of the season. So it's no surprise that there's a lot of rabbits running around in your yard right now. Now, granted, they don't all last.
Well, sure, and I was going to talk about that. There aren't, as far as in the city, though. What are the predators of rabbits in the city?
Well, you can have a lot of things. Rabbits are delicious, and there's they're a very sought after species from a hunting perspective throughout most of the East Coast. But everything from neighborhood cats to coyotes to hawks and owls will take them. If you're in a little opener area. But they certainly are eaten by just about any carnivore in the environment, just because they are tasty and the young ones are naive and pretty easy prey. So, we'd be up to our armpits in rabbits if it wasn't for all of those predators.
I do feel like I was in the backyard weeding last week, and I literally sat right next to this tiny little bunny, and I picked it up and it just sat in my hand, and I was like, dude, you're gonna die.
You're not supposed to pick it up, Megan.
I know, but if I didn't...
Professor, will you please scold Megan for
if I didn't move
picking
it,
up the rabbit?
Lloyd was definitely gonna get it, so I just moved it over to the trees and was like, go fend for yourself over there.
Yeah, it's tough. The likelihood of a rabbit being born in the summertime, the likelihood of them getting around to that next summer is about 10%,
No kidding.
And about 1% if you think about it, making it to its second summer. So it's tough. It's a tough life if you're a rabbit. The likelihood of you surviving is pretty small.
What kind of rabbits do we have here in Minnesota? Are all of the ones we're seeing cottontails, or do we have other varieties too?
Well, you mostly have eastern cottontails. That would be the most common residential species. They're kind of off-brown. Males and females look very similar. I can see the video you've got is a great example. You've got that rusty nape of the neck that's really identifying. But we do have in Minnesota 2 other rabbit species that are commonly found. There's the snowshoe hare that's more common up in the northeast part of the state, in the Arrowhead and such. They tend to be more coniferous. They've got bigger ears and bigger feet. hence the name snowshoe hare. And then if you're out in the prairie regions, you know, places that used to be mostly prairies, then you have white-tailed jackrabbits as well. And they are, you know, an eastern cottontail is maybe 2 to 3 pounds, snowshoe hares maybe 4 or 5 pounds, and jackrabbits are more like 9 pounds, much, much bigger. So they've got really large ears, great example there, and very large feet.
Have you ever seen a jackrabbit, Megan?
I have.
They are insane. It's crazy to You're see like a jackrabbit rabbit compared to a regular cottontail.
Yeah, they're huge.
So we're showing, I don't know why we're fixated on this. We're showing some ridiculous video of rabbits fighting each other in the yard. And we wanted to address the kicking power of rabbits for whatever reason. We felt this was important to address. So they're pretty strong kickers, it sounds like.
They are really strong kickers. You know, a naive user might think that they're all soft and furry and cuddly and very gentle. But, you know, if you've ever handled a rabbit, you know that they have tremendous strength in those back feet. And those back feet are you know, their toes have nails on them that are quite, you know, they can give you quite a scratch as well. So as someone who's handled rabbits, it's something you want to be pretty cautious about. Not something for your average homeowner who catches one in a live trap and thinks, well, I'll just reach in there and grab them. They're you know, they're gentle. No, they can when threatened, they can defend themselves.
And I always thought rabbits were boxers.
Just in the cartoons.
I know. John, give us your favorite fun fact or interesting note about rabbits. Something that when you tell people, they go, what? Really? I had no idea.
Well, there's a couple of fun facts, right? Obviously, the reproductive capacity that they can produce, you know, over 20 youngsters in a season here in Minnesota. Oh, by the way, if you're in Louisiana, it's double that. The other fun facts, I teach a course on mammals, and rabbits have incisors, just, you know, those buck teeth that we often think of, but they actually have a second set of, they're called peg teeth, right behind those incisors, which is kind of a fun fact. And I guess I'd say the third fun fact is, and this one's a little less family friendly, but rabbits are coprophagic. They produce actually two kinds of fecal pellets. One same fecal pellet that you and I produce that we don't want to touch again. But they also produce their gut has a lot of bacteria in it, and they ferment some of the vegetation that they do. So they also produce a second kind of fecal pellet that's soft and really full of nutrients that they then re-ingest and consume. You know, they consume that to take advantage of the gut bacteria helping digest that that material, and the place that it happens is in the lower reaches of the duct, you know, the large intestine. So they get a chance to sort of digest their food twice, and it's a great evolutionary adaptation on living in a sparse environment. You know, think about what's out there for a rabbit to eat in the middle of winter. Not a lot. So they have to really process it hard to get all the nutrients they can out of it.
John, that was a really fun fact. Thank you. That was
gross.
Awesome. And gross, but it was
and
awesome.
Gross. Sorry.
Awesome. Well, John,
those are the most memorable anyway.
Yeah, for sure. This has been a lot of fun. We need to have you back.
Anytime.
All right. Sounds good. We'll post all kinds of information about rabbits for you on MinnesotaLive.com.